morning, sir. Good morning, classmates. I am Eleanor C. Hanubas from Libby Integrated School, Malapatan 2 District. My topic is all about evaluation plan, staffing plan, and budget. What is evaluation plan? Evaluation plan is a written document that describes how you will monitor and evaluate your program so that you will be able to describe what and how and why it matters for your program and use evaluation results for program improvement and decision making. What is evaluation plan? This is one way of monitoring program to know why it happened, how the program works, and what if this will happen. It helps us on making decision and on how we are going to improve the program that we have in our department. In evaluation plan, there are some reasons that we consider. Number one is it guides you through each step of the process of evaluation. It guides us in every step we do in processing an evaluation plan. Number two, it helps you decide what sort of information you and your stakeholders really need. It helps us decide what information our organization and to our stakeholders that they need. In every organization, we all have a stakeholders to support us, and they should be informed of what program that we have in our department or in our organization. Next is it keeps you from wasting time gathering information that isn't needed. It helps us to it can help us avoid an information that is not needed in our department. Example, we only need a necessary information for our department. Number four, it helps you identify the best possible methods and strategies for getting the needed information. It helps us identify the best possible method and strategies to get the information needed in our organization. Number five, it helps you come up with a reasonable and realistic timeline for evaluation. It helps us to come up with a realistic timeline of evaluation. Pag sinasabing realistic timeline, kumbaga makatutuhanan siya and nasa tamang panahon natin siya magagamit, or nasa tamang panahon siya and hindi tayo ma-short ng time, hindi din tayo malalampas doon sa panahon kung saan kailangan na natin ma-evaluate yung ating program. And the next is number six, it most importantly, it will improve your initiative. Evaluation plan can give us more initiative in implementing our program. It can give us more ideas in our example, in our best practices. While we apply our best practices in our department, we come up with some initiative that can help on how we are going to improve our program in this particular department. And next is, when should you develop an evaluation plan? Sabi dito, the best time to do this is before you implement the initiative. After that, you can do any time, but the earlier you develop it and begin to implement it, the better off your initiative will be, and the greater the outcomes will be at the end. Remember, evaluation is more than just finding out if you did your job. It also important to use evaluation data to improve the initiative along the way. Before you implement the program, first, you have already an evaluation plan. The earlier you develop, the greater the outcomes will be. Remember, evaluation plan is not just finding the outcome, or if you did your job, but to improve the initiative along the way. While you implement the program, you also have the initiative on how it developed, or on how you manage the program in your department. Staffing plan. What is staffing plan? It is a strategic planning process by which a company assesses and identifies the personnel's needs of the organization. In other words, a good staffing plan helps you understand the number and types of employees our organization needs to accomplish its goals. Staffing plan is a strategy of human resource team that assesses and identifies the needs of personnel of the organization. Pag sinasabing needs of personnel of an organization, in every organization, we all have our needs to improve, needs to develop. That's why in every organization, there are workshop, training, seminars that the organization initiate for the employees or for the personnel could be improved of what they were or what are the assignments that we have in the organization. A good staffing plan helps us understand the number and types of employees that our organization needs to accomplish its goals. In every organization, we all have the goals that we have in our department. And because of that goals, we have the evaluation plan para malaman natin kung yung ating program is tama ba dun sa ating department or sa ating organization. Also, identify, sabi nga dito, also staffing plan, identify the headcounts of departments, skills, and knowledge that might needed in the organization. This plan is used during budget cycles to help in allocating budget cost. It could be used anytime in the adjustment of a workplace. Sinasabing budget, yung human resource team, alam nila yan, kung paano kung gagawa tayo ng mga trainings, ng mga seminars na ganito, ilan dapat ang budget, ilan dapat ang magagastos, yun yung sa staffing plan. Next, staffing, this includes the activities of hiring the full-time or past-time employees, hiring contractors, and terminating employees' contract. Sinasabi sa organization or sa isang institution, like for example, the Department of Education, meron tayong hinahire na mga teacher na hindi pa nakapasa. Like for example, sa senior high school department, sa senior high school, may mga nakapasok sa DepEd na hindi pa sila nakapasa sa DepEd because of yung sinasabing contractors, may mga kontrata pa, may mga pinipirma na sila, or may mga sinusunod dun kung bakit ka na-hire, dahil kailangan namin yung skills at talents mo. Ganito yun. Includes, dito natin malalaman, identifying and fulfilling talents needs. Ito yung nasa staffing plan, nasa human resource team. Identifying and fulfilling talents needs. Yung talent mo, tapos sa isang school, kailangan namin dito ang isang teacher na marunong siya mag-welding. Kailangan yung mag-apply na maging senior high school teacher ay isang welder. Yun yung sinasabing identify natin yung skills na meron si applicant. Ganon. Number two, utilizing various recruitment technologies to acquire a high volume of applicants. When you say utilize, gagamitin yung mga paraan para maraming mag-a-apply. For example, sa Department of Education, i-announce siya sa kada school o sa kada barangay. Kung sino yung nakapasa dyan, sige, magpasa na kayo ng folder, ganito, you have to bring this one doon sa division office para ma-hire ka kung deserving ka na kompleto yung kapilis mo o yung mga papers mo, ganun. Next, terminating contracts when necessary. Sinasabi terminating contracts, halimbawa yung senior high school na applicant, nakapasok siya, nakapasok sa lahat, mayroon siyang skills, mayroon talents, mayroon siyang in situ, mayroon siyang limang in situ, at saka kailangan niya ng school because of the senior high school students na o-opening this coming school year, i-hire nila. Pero, andun yung tinatawag na provisionary. Hanggat wala pang mag-a-apply na let passer, tapos kailangan nila ang skills mo, hina-hire ka. Pero pagdating ng panahon na may mag-apply, tapos kapareho mo na in situ passer, may skills din, tapos nakapasa sa let, tapos ikaw wala, kailangan na papalitan ka nung nakapasa sa let. Yun yung sinasabing may 5 years sila na chance para mag-exam sa let. Pag makapasa, sa kanila yung item. Ganun yung terminating contracts when necessary. Kailangan aalis ka talaga kasi may papalit na sa'yo na nakapasa sa let. Next, maintaining ethical hiring practices and aligning with the regulatory environment. Pag mag-hire, kailangan naka-inline dun sa pangangailangan din ng school or sa pangangailangan ng department. Eh, hindi mo kailangan yung English major, tapos may nag-apply, tapos friend mo, tapos gusto mong siya yung makapasok, hindi pwede. Kasi ang kailangan mo is agriculture. Ang nag-apply is English major. Ang dapat na tatanggapin mo is yung agriculture. Kasi nga, doon tayo naka-align sa kung ano yung pangailangan ng isang department. Ano yung kailangan ng isang department, yun yung i-hire para ma-meet natin yung goal ng isang department. Next, budget plan. Pag sinasabing budget plan, ano yun siya? When you say budget, speak about money. Sabi nga dito, budget is an estimation of revenue and expenses over a specified future or period of time and usually compiled and re-evaluated on a periodic basis. Budget can be made for a person, a group of people, a business, a government, or just about anything else that makes and spends money. Sabi dito, budget can be made for a person. Bawa tao, sabi nga, mag-spend ka ng money, dapat unahin mo yung itago na pera, tapos kung ano yung kailangan mong ispend, yun yung ispend, tapos kung ano yung bibilhin mo na mga gadgets, yung ganun, bago ka bibili, yung itapag muna para hindi ka ma-short, hindi ka malulubog sa utang. Yun yung budget. And a group of people, halimbawa sa isang organization, group of people, kailangan din yung budget. Halimbawa sa isang school, yung imuwi na isang buwan ay ibibili ni principal sa, bibili si principal na flat screen. Dalawang section, para sa dalawang section yun. Sa grade 7, section 1, sa section 2, yun yung magbabudget ng group of people, di ba? Sa isang organization. Sinasabi ng mga business, pag sinasabing business, talagang may budget ka na para dyan sa business mo. Next is ang government. Pag sinasabing government, sa government kasi, kada taon, every annually, na may sinasabing silang budgeting plan na from the month of October, November, nagbe-budget dyan sila for the next, next full year. Yun yung sa government. Or, anything else that makes and spends money, yan ay sinasabing budget. Meron tayong tinatawag na 3 types of budget. Meron tayong balance budget, meron tayong surplus budget, and meron tayong deficit budget. A government budget is said to be a balanced budget if the estimated government expenses is equal to expected government receipts, in particular financial year. Government is said to be a balanced budget if the estimated government expenses is equal. Ano yung estimated na na expenses, yun din yung tinatawag na tama lang siya dun sa pera na meron kayo sa isang department, yun ay ang balanced budget. Ano yung na-spend mo, ano yung budget na meron ka sa isang organization, balance yun. Pag sinasabi namang a government budget is said to be a surplus budget if the expected government revenues exceed the estimated government expenditure in a particular financial year. Pag sinasabing surplus, ang expected government revenue ay sobra. Halimbawa, yung tax na binabayad natin is yung tax na binabayad is sobra siya sa kailangan ng department. Halimbawa, merong nalikom na pera na 100,000 tapos hindi siya naubos sa isang taon. Ibig sabihin, yung natira na pera, yun yung surplus budget. Next, budgetary deficit is the sum of revenue account deficit and capital account deficit. If revenue expenses of the government exceed revenue receipts, it results in revenue account deficit. Similarly, if the capital disbursement of the government exceed capital receipts, it leads to capital account deficit. Sabi dito, if revenue expense of the government exceed the revenue receipts, it results the revenue account deficit. Halimbawa, sobra yung nagastos mo sa pera na meron kayo sa department, ibig sabihin na deficit yun. And yung capital naman na meron kayo sa gobyerno, tapos sumusobra dun sa na-spend mo na money, yun naman ay tinatawag na capital account deficit. Yung capital disbursement of the government exceed the capital receipts, it leads to capital deficit. And that's all. Thank you and God bless.